From the EPAWA headquarters in South Allentown, Pennsylvania, it's time for Weather Weeklies, an informative video of the ins and outs of weather that affect you most in the EPAWA coverage area. The following segment is a weekly video blog, and the opinions of the forecaster do not necessarily reflect the opinions of the staff of Eastern PA Weather Authority LLC as a whole, nor its constituents. Without further ado, here is meteorologist Bobby Marchers with Weather Weeklies.
And good Sunday morning to another edition of Weather Weeklies for Sunday, December 4th. Of course, the calendar has turned to another month, and we are now into meteorological winter, and that means generally this is when the fun starts. Well, the next couple weeks won't really disappoint if that's your thing. If you're liking cold and snow, we're going to get into that into this video. I do think we have a turn toward that, and it's pretty evident on the ensembles. We're going to show you what we're looking at. First, we'll start off a long-range table like we always do in every video. This comes out every Friday with a public long-range. We did expect the first week of December to be near to slightly above normal. We're seeing that. But we also noted that the first week of December, that it wasn't impossible to see some snow. And that would have to be perfectly timed because the temperatures were still a little bit too warm overall. But the bigger systems wouldn't wait until at least the second week of December when we had the cold in place, and that is still on target. Okay, so now here's the first week. We have near to slightly above normal temperatures, but in a case like tonight into tomorrow morning, and I'll show you that snow map in case you missed it, we have a little minor event. Now, not a lot of snow, but just enough that some areas will get some accumulation out of it, and it's perfectly timed, coming in during the overnight hours. So we said that opportunity would be there the first week. There it is. Another chance, maybe Tuesday, the beginning of a rain event for far northern areas, and another one maybe later in the week with the Arctic frontal boundary coming in. That's going to change this pattern, finally. Now, I use a term loosely, because people have different opinions of what a pattern change is. Listen, if you're used to above normal, above normal, above normal every single month, and then you get a period, even if it's only a couple weeks, of below normal cold, and you change the temperatures for the month of December to below normal for the, we're actually expected to average below normal this month, not by a lot, but by below normal, you have to go back some places in our coverage area, some 21 months. Back to 2015, the winter of 2015, when the last time you saw temperatures below normal for a month. And we're projecting that this month, okay? So it's going to be awfully close. And, you know, so it does, I don't know what you really are looking for if you want a pattern change. I mean, it, don't be saying it's going to be like this and, you know, straight through the end of March, and that's what defines a pattern change. A lot of people have different opinions on it. Look, the pattern's changing. That's the bottom line. So now the question is, well, how long does it hold? All right, we know through the 17th it should be okay. After that point, the ensembles are kind of split, and some are indicating they might have like a little bit of a warmer period a week leading up to Christmas. Now, that's also warm relative to average. Now, the normal highs this time of year are in the 30s for most places, upper 30s at this time frame. So if you're slightly above, you're still in the low 40s. Don't read too much into that. Don't read too much into that, hey, it's going to be too warm to snow. It's going to be a blowtorch. It's not going to be a blowtorch, okay? It's going to be, if it does go above, it'll be slightly. And it means you're in your lower 40s in your same boat you are here in week one, okay? Still can have snow. Not impossible. So, anyway, that being said, we have a couple systems coming in here, the first of which will be tonight. Here's our snow map that we put out last night on the Facebook page and the website. And this is what we're looking at. Generally, a coating inch in these light blue areas, 1 to 2 inches up here in the darker blue. This area here in the area labeled C could have some isolated coatings, but for the most part, this is just a mix of rain and snow without absent of accumulations. Okay, so it looks like your accumulations are going to be a little south of I-78 here. I-78 kind of runs like this between Harrisburg and Allentown up in northwest New Jersey, so it's going to be a little south of that, maybe from like Quakertown northward. And maybe just north of, right down here by, I don't even know these towns anymore. I used to know these towns very well. I used to go in and out of Morgantown. There we go. So one of what I was thinking of here in southern Berks County. Morgantown, probably north of there. All right. You know, just some minor accumulations. Harrisburg might get into that. Once you get up the mountains up here, you could have some areas that are be closer to, because you're going to be all snow up in the area. And it kind of looks funky here. There's a little cutout here. But there's not a lot of precipitation available. So these areas here These are all mountainous regions. So those are the generally 1 to 2 inch areas that's going to be tonight. As far as the pattern change, though, now, again, I'm using this term loosely. Call it a pattern shift. Call it just a change, whatever you want to call it, okay? This is what we are looking at right now, okay? This is as of Sunday morning. This is the European ensembles. Cold out here in this area here. This is all cold air, okay? But you got higher heights over here, higher heights. Now, you see what this is doing. It's showing above normal here, but is it really? I mean, you're only talking about today being near normal. So as far as 500 millibars, it's really not above normal. This isn't an awful pattern because we're going to get snow tonight. Not a lot, again, but you see this is an awful. All right, but when we go forward, things are going to start changing. This is going out to about December 8th, and you have a big trough digging in here in the center of the country, and that is going to be pressing eastward toward our area that will get here by about the 9th. The leading edge of this will be a cold front that will come through here on Thursday in our area. Now, normally when you look at this and you say, I don't know, well, you get this big low in the Gulf of Alaska. See this here? There's a big trough in the Gulf of Alaska. Usually this is a bad thing, okay? Usually that's a bad thing. But we have what's called an omega ridge or omega block sitting right here. It looks like the Greek letter omega. See that right there? This blocking pattern creates a negative EPO. If you remember back to the 2013-2014 season, not a very good setup that year. We had a very fast specific jet. For most of the country, it was really warm. However, that negative EPO saved us and got that cross-polar flow going where we were very cold here in the northeast United States. We had a lot of nickel and dime events that year that added up to a lot of snow. Okay? So it can definitely happen. A negative EPO can save you. This is what it's showing right now. This is a omega block induced, mega ridge induced negative EPO. Okay, so it doesn't matter that this is here. Everybody's jumping on it. Oh, there's a low in the Gulf of Alaska. Yeah, typically that's a problem. Not when you have this here. That feature is sitting there. Now again, this is December 8th. We're going to go to the end of the run now. Same thing, European ensembles. And you still have all this cold here. Still a very fast Pacific jet. Maybe like, oh no, fast Pacific jet. You got another low in the Gulf of Alaska. That's going to be a blowtorch. Well, no, it's not. Because guess what's still here? The omega block. Still there. Omega block is still there. So you still have a negative EPO. And that means we are going to be colder. And that's going to be sustained at least until the 17th or so. You can see that here. We're still on the colder side of things here. So we're in a pretty active period. This is actually showing an active period but on the, if you're looking at the 500 millibar chart here. Okay? So it should be an active couple weeks. And we go from this in the first 5 days of the month. This is all where the below normal temperatures are here out west from Alaska, western Canada. If you remember before we had all those areas in western Canada that just had no snow because it was so warm. Well, and it's not warm there anymore. Not at all. As a matter of fact, when it's showing warm here over Hudson Bay, that's not warm either. That's called warm relative to average. This is anomalous warmth for them. But so instead of being minus 10, it's maybe 10 degrees above. Well, whoop-dee-doo. It's still cold. It's still cold as the snow. So don't let that deceive you. Okay? A lot of people seem to get that confused. This is anomalies. This is temperature anomaly. Okay? So yeah, it's above normal. It's about 7 or so degrees above normal. But for there, that's not a big deal. Still cold, still below freezing, still snowing up there. Okay, now the whole point here now in our area, that doesn't work that way. Because we're obviously warmer on the warmer side of things. If it's above normal here, it's probably not snowing. Now all this stuff, this is what it looks like here in the first week of the month. Go to the second week of the month, look what happens. Boom. We're down the bottom now on the below normal temperatures. All of Canada virtually is below normal as well. Okay? So this is all below normal temperature anomalies, and that's what we're heading into. Okay? This is going after the 13th. The EPS actually goes out to the 18th, and it does show signs that that negative EPO that we're showing in that previous image, that mega block here, might finally start breaking down at that point. I don't want to take that for granted because every time we see this get closer to this, it seems like it wants to hold on to this omega ridge longer. So we'll see how that works out. I don't want to speculate. That's why we let this cause a little bit of uncertainty here. And we put sea pattern discussion 18th to 24th. We really don't know yet. I don't want to jump on that in one way or the other and say, yeah, it's going to be warm or yeah, it's going to be cold or maybe something in between. We don't know that yet. Leaning in toward the pattern continuing for a while, but we'll see. Okay, we'll see. That's one of those things that happened at long range forecasting. You just have to wait and see how things develop over the next couple model cycles and see how we're progressing going forward. Okay, now here's what they with the ensembles. The ensembles are they have the GFS, you have the Canadian, you have the European model, blah blah blah. They all have their own group of ensembles, which is the same model run an additional X amount of times. Different set of algorithms with each one, but like the GFS, for example, runs an additional 20 times. The European model runs an additional 50 times. Okay, if you take those individual members, here's the GEFS, that's the GFS ensembles. All right, here's what the operational shows: total snowfall in the next couple of weeks. Total snowfall. Well, it doesn't show a whole lot. All right, and most of this is probably this event coming in tonight. But look at the individual ensembles. There's number 1, number 2, number 3, all the way up to number 20. And then it averages them together at the end here. Look at that. A lot snowier to look than this here. That's just the GFS operational. The ensemble members are a little bit more aggressive here with snowfall. Some pretty high amounts of snow. You can just go through each one of these and you can see that. Pretty decent amounts of snow working in here. If you average them all together, you get that. Now, if you just think of anything, if you're trying to, come up with a batting average in baseball. You know, if you're saying you're a 300 hitter, you don't say that after you played, played three games and you have 10 at bats and you got three hits. Yeah, you're a 300 hitter for that period, but does that mean you're going to sustain that for the whole season? Probably not. Or maybe you do. Maybe you improve it. I doubt at the end of the season though. You need a bigger size sample, and that's what the whole idea behind the ensembles. You have a couple different things. You don't just have to look at one operational run. You're looking at many here. Okay, so but by the end of the day, you get this for a blend, and you say, oh well, that's a lot more than this. So obviously, something might not be right here with the European or the GFS operational run. So that's the idea. So that's a snowier look. Guess what? Here's the European ensemble snowier look, too. This is total snowfall, and this is a smoothed-down mean, okay? So this is blending them all of them together at a lower resolution, and this line right here, this purple starts a 6-inch line. This is a total over the next 2 weeks. That's a decent amount of snow, but the whole idea here is it's favoring the interior for heavy snow up in this area. Close to the coast, you get less, but it's still showing snow close to the coast. Which I found is very interesting. And every time this runs, this has been running the last couple weeks, same thing with the GFS going out pretty far, it keeps creeping this down further and further south. So I do think we're going to get an active period here the next couple weeks of snowfall. How much is yet to be determined. We're going to deal that on individual basis, and then we're going to see how long this period lasts of cold, whether that goes into the end of the month. Maybe we just get a little bit of a break for a couple days, maybe right before Christmas or thereabout, and then it gets back cold again. Maybe it goes warm. Maybe it stays warm. I don't want to speculate. I don't think that happens. A lot of people are saying that, we have our winter in the beginning and that's it. I really don't think that's going to be the case, but we'll see. See how that works, and this is why we do these videos and why we do the long-range updates every week. We kind of adjust with what the pattern's giving us, and right now it looks good for the next couple of weeks. After that, once you get past 2 weeks, you're really just throwing pennies in a fish pond here, because you really don't know what you're doing. Once you get past that point, things change constantly. One thing I do know is if you have not gotten the winter weather text alerts, either one county or two county alerts for text alerts, which gives you the snow information, the timing, start end times, like we sent out yesterday and we're going to send out again today with updates. Get on this program. This is our weather, My Pocket Meteorologist weather alerts specific to the county you live in. You don't have to wait for the public maps to come out. You get all the information. We sent the information out 6 hours yesterday prior to our release of the public snow map, and it was specific to your county. You don't have to guess. You don't have to wait for a snow map to come out. Same thing with the forum. We've been discussing this, not this event, because we only get 1 day notice of this one because it's such a minor event, but we will talk about bigger storm systems coming in the next couple weeks in our premium forum. We really geek it out here and talk about, you can interact with the meteorologist. We don't do that on Facebook or Twitter. This is where we really get down and dirty with the model analysis, and I think we're going to be finally doing model analysis for the first time within the next 2 weeks. Haven't had to do that yet, even with this minor event. We're only talking about an inch or two at most for the system tonight, so that's not really a model analysis type deal. But once we get into bigger storm threats, we're definitely going to get into a very comprehensive model analysis and discussions in that premium forum. So you can get the premium forum as an add-on for just $30 a year if you already have another service. The $24.99, $34.99 is for, covers you for the entire winter. For your county, you get all the text alerts, anything wintry or even non-wintry heading toward your county will cost you $24.99 for the entire season, $34.99 if you want two county coverage instead of one for commuting and things like that. I'm Eastern PA Weather Authority meteorologist Bobby Marchers. That is this edition of Weather Weeklies for Sunday, December 4th. We'll see you again next week.